Hi, everybody. Welcome to Science Around Town. My name is Ryan Hollister. I'm the secondary science coach for Turlock Unified School District. And today, I hope you'll join me on trying to explore the origin story of some really weird boulders that are sitting in a parking lot on the corner of Colorado and Lyon Street in Turlock, across from the district office. So let's go explore these rocks and figure out why they're so cool and so interesting. So we're going to use Google Earth Web to virtually take this tour. And at the end of this video, there will be a link so you too can also go on this tour virtually and experience it for yourself and play around with some of the 3D models that are in here. So this is an overview of Turlock. It looks nice and lovely. And the rocks in question that we really want to view and take a look at are these rocks right over here called TUSD, Table Mountain Laetite. So here's the parking lot, and here are the boulders in question. And if you notice, this Google Street View is not the clearest. So I went and took a whole bunch of photographs and made these rocks into 3D models that we can all look at. So hopefully we can get some clues just by looking at this rock to figure out what type of rock it is, and then maybe we can hunt down where it came from. So if I zoom in on this particular boulder, and there's the end of a tip of a mechanical pencil down there, just so you get an idea of how big this rock is. It's maybe 3 feet wide and a couple feet tall. You'll notice there's a bunch of bumps and holes in this rock. And anywhere there's bumps and holes, and I'll show you it's the same on this other rock that is right next door to it that I made. Anytime you find rocks with bumps and holes like this, those are gas bubbles that geologists call vesicles. And vesicles pretty much only form in rocks that are volcanic, have been erupted out of a volcano. And as the lava tries to flow out, gases escape. And as those gases escape, they leave bubbles in the lava. So not all that gas is going to escape. And as that lava cools down and crystallizes and hardens, it's going to trap some of those bubbles in there. And if you break the rock open, you're going to see the holes or the voids, the vesicles of where that gas used to be. So right away, we know, ooh, this rock in the parking lot is a volcanic rock. Now, where did it come from? What are the clues? Well, when I took a look at these rocks up close, I noticed a couple of things. I noticed that some of the rocks were a little bit orange, and then other part of that same rock was dark gray. And as a geologist, one of the things we always try to do is find the true color of the rock to help us identify it. And it turns out that this orange color is oxidation or rust from the rock having been sitting out somewhere exposed to the surface, exposed to the weather, exposed to rain and sun, and it actually rusted a little bit and turned orange. But if you scrape that away, you can find that the true color of the rock is really pretty gray, and there's big white crystals that are in it too. And so if you go back and take a look at a zoomed in high resolution shot, we can see that these white things happen to be minerals called feldspar that are stuck within this big gray volcanic rock that have really small crystals. And so that's another thing that makes this rock really weird is when lava normally erupts, it crystallizes really fast and has small crystals. So to find lava with big crystals in it is really unusual and really weird, but there it is. And it's also a telltale sign, like a chemical signature, that it came from a very specific spot. So where is that very specific spot? Well, to give you a sense of where we're going to be headed, here is a nice overview of the area we're going to cover here in just a few minutes. So we're going to go as far east as Sonora Pass, which is over by Dodge Ridge, or maybe you know Pinecrest Lake, those areas. It's in that neck of the woods. And then we're going to follow the Stanislaus River down through like Jamestown, Sonora, or Sonora, Jamestown, and then Oakdale, and figure out where this rock came from. So we're going to start with a story that's about 30 million years old. 30 million years ago, there was a very large volcano in the eastern part of Nevada, which we now know as Ely. And that volcano erupted in a situation where the Earth looked like this. So modern day Oakdale, Knight's Ferry, that would have been pretty much near the edge of the continent 30 million years ago. Turlock didn't exist yet. We were still under the ocean. So what's kind of cool is that volcanic eruption laid down thousands of feet of ash all the way over where we live in the eastern, or in California here. And over time, about 28 million years ago, between 28 and 10 million years ago, rivers started cutting down through that ash, just like you're seeing in my model I made in my backyard here. It cut down through the ash and made big river canyons over 18 million years or so. So that's the first part of the story. Volcano in Nevada put a bunch of ash over where the eastern Sierras are today. Rivers cut through it. Then about 10.8 million years ago or so, some weird things started happening at what we know as Sonora Pass today. Literally, the ground kind of fissured open and split open and cracked open, and it would have looked something similar to what you see in this picture right here, with lava just erupting out in these big, long cracks and flowing for very, very long distances, in some cases over 60 miles. So it just would have been this crazy volcanic landscape. And what you can see in some of these pictures here is these are the lava flows that have been left over. So it built up, in some cases, hundreds, and in some cases, over 1,000 feet of lava flows being built up over time. And these are my friends, Callan and Jason, and where we're standing right here in this photo, that is an actual vent. That was what we call a feeder dike. This is where magma was actually squeezing up through the earth and then erupting on the surface. So this right here, along 10.8 million years ago, was liquid magma that was squeezing up to the surface to become lava. So what does all of this look like up close? Well, if you hike just around the corner from Sonora Pass at a place called Blue Canyon, you can actually go down in there and pick up the volcanic rocks, and you can find some really interesting similarities to the ones that are in the Turlock. Notice the light gray rock. It's also called a laetite, and we see those big white minerals of feldspar again, those crystals, mineral crystals of feldspar that are very conspicuous. So as geologists, we say, ooh, all of those look like they have the same DNA. They're probably the same rock. And it turns out they are. So how did we get from the Table Mountain laetite up high in Sonora Pass? How did it end up down near Jamestown? Or how do we even know it's down near Jamestown? Well, we'll take a look here in just a second. So I'm going to play the whole rest of this video here. We saw that the river, between 28 and 10 million years ago, it eroded a big canyon. And after that canyon was eroded, about 10.8 million years ago or so, the volcanoes in Sonora Pass started erupting, like you're seeing right here. And those lavas flowed down the old river channels that had been cut into the ash, filled up the river channels, solidified, hardened, and then over the next 10 million years, rain and weathering and all the other kind of stuff eroded the softer ash layers off to the side, and left the more resistant lava, the Table Mountain laetite, high and dry. So we call this inverse topography or inverted topography, because what used to be the riverbed and the river channel is now a big mountain sitting on top. And it turns out that the name of this mountain is, surprise, surprise, Table Mountain. So if you take a look over here, you can actually see these nice sinuous paths. Let me get my pointer here. These nice sinuous paths are the old Stanislaus River channel flowing down where the lava flowed down, solidified, hardened, and cooled off. Everything else around it eroded away. The Dardanelles are another example up there where you can find some more of that. But if you want to go explore this on your own after quarantine is over, you can actually hike to the top of Table Mountain to see what is up on the top. And it turns out this is what the view would look like. You have really amazing views hiking across what used to be the bottom of a riverbed that was filled in by lava, and then you're now hiking on top of the lava flow, and the canyon around you has all been washed away. And if you break open the rocks on top of Table Mountain, again, you find that, hey, look at that. There's the laetite, the nice grayish rock surrounding those white feldspar crystals. So again, this is the same type of rock that erupted from up by Sonora Pass. So it's really gorgeous, and not only do you have the crystals there, but you have tons of wildflowers here as well that only grow on top of Table Mountain, because there's not very many animals that get up there to graze it, and it's kind of a unique ecosystem. So it's a special place to go if you ever get a chance to. It's a really easy hike as well. but only go after quarantine is over. So we're going to jump then from Table Mountain out of the riverbed there down to near Knight's Ferry. And we're going to take a look and compare some of the rocks in the road cut here to the rocks down in Turlock. And if you notice, the rocks in Turlock look very similar to these rocks that are piled on the side of the road right here. And if I take a closer look, because I've been there many times, if you cut the rocks away there or break them open, guess what? It's Table Mountain laytite as well. It's the nice gray laytite surrounding the white crystals of feldspar that are in the rocks. And this is how we know it's chemically identical. It's related to the rocks that came from Sonora Pass and flowed all the way down the river channel. And so this is basically the end of the road for the lava flow near Knight's Ferry. If you've ever been hiking near Knight's Ferry, that lava that erupted all the way up, way back up here by Sonora Pass, flowed down the old Stanislaus River channel 10 million years ago, flowed about 60 miles down to where Knight's Ferry is today. So how did all those rocks that flowed down from there reach Turlock? Well, the lava flows never reached Turlock, but people like to make money, and some people, like rock sellers, will gather the rocks on their property and sell them as a quarry for people to put them in their lawns and in their gardens as decoration. So that is where the Table Mountain laytite comes from. So the next time you happen to be walking around Turlock and you happen to be seeing these rocks sitting on the parking lot right across the street from the district office, you can know that the story of these rocks were it was erupted out of a volcano, that the lava filled a river channel, the river channel solidified, and all of the stuff around it eroded away, left behind the lava rocks, and then 10 million years after it was erupted, somebody put it on a truck and brought it to Turlock and stuck it right here on the corner for us to enjoy. If you'd like to enjoy this on your own, here is the link, the Google link to this virtual tour. You can go take a look at it on your own and play around, and hopefully this will inspire you to go see this in person once the coronavirus has passed. And thanks very much. I hope you have a great evening.